Thelma and the Lost Teddy, and this is by author David McKee. The sky was already dark and full of stars when Elma, the patchwork elephant, heard the sound of crying. It was baby elephant. "He can't sleep," said baby elephant's mother. "He wants his teddy. We took teddy with us on a picnic and somewhere we lost it." "Never mind," said Elma. "I'll lend him my teddy. Tomorrow I'll look for the lost one." Elma went away and came back with his teddy. Baby elephant smiled and was soon fast asleep with Elma's teddy beside him. The next day, Elma set off in search of the lost teddy. He hadn't gone far when he met his cousin Wilbur. "Hello, Wilbur," said Elma. "I'm looking for baby elephant's lost teddy. Have you seen it?"
"No," said Wilbur.
"But if I find it, I'll call you." A little later, a voice said,
"Hello, Elma. Where are you going?"
It was Lion. "Baby elephant has lost his teddy and I'm looking for it," said Elma.
"Oh dear," said Lion. "Baby Lion would be very upset if he lost his teddy. If I find it, I'll call you. Maybe Tiger has seen it."
As he came near Tiger's place, Elma called out, "Yo-ho, Tiger!"
"Shh, Elma,"
Tiger quietly called back.
"The twins are asleep."
"Sorry," said Elma. "Only baby elephant has lost his teddy. Have you seen it?"
"Very serious," said Tiger. "The twins wouldn't sleep without their teddies. If I find it, I'll call you."
After that, Elma visited the other animals. All the young ones had their teddies, but none of them had seen baby elephants. They all said the same thing. "If we find it, we'll call you." It was getting late into the afternoon and Teddy was still lost. "I hope I find him soon," thought Elma. "It's nearly night time." It was at that moment that he heard a shout.
"Help! Help!"
And then again,
"Help! I'm lost!"
Elma pushed through some bushes and there was a teddy bear. The voice came from the teddy.
"Please help me," said Teddy. "I'm lost. I want baby elephant."
"You can talk," said Elma in surprise.
"Please take me home," said Teddy. "I can't sleep without baby elephant."
Elma still stared. "Your mouth isn't moving," he said. Just then Wilbur appeared from the bushes.
"Wilbur," laughed Elma, "I might have known it was you making Teddy speak."
Wilbur chuckled. "I said I'd call if I found Teddy," he said, "and I did. Come on, let's take Teddy home. It's getting dark." They set off together, singing as they went. Baby Elephant was excited to see his Teddy again and quickly gave back Elma's Teddy. Baby Elephant's mother couldn't thank Elma and Wilbur enough. "Elma," said Wilbur, "weren't you worried that baby elephant would want to keep your teddy? Your teddy is very different. It's special."
"But Wilbur, didn't you know," said Elma in surprise, "you don't have to be different to be special. All teddies are special, especially your own."
Dee.